Hey guys, it's KJ for you. Welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single player Let's Play. It's S-11 Season 11, we're episode 24. And last episode, we blew up our bridge, and now we are just rebuilding it. And I'm just kind of giving a little bit more support underneath. Like so. As a matter of fact, we're going to need a lot more stone. I think soon I'll go do some TNT mining or something. I just want this stuff to line up properly underneath. Not that it really matters, but I like the extra, support under here. Okay, that might have come up too far. I don't know where the zombies are. I'm very happy they're not here. I might have cleared out the area last time I was here. There we go. And we could do that side later. This side's good right here. So this comes out three. One, two, three. Yeah, that one's supported. That one's supported. One, two, three. Okay, now we're lined up and working. Everything is going good. Now that we line stuff up, we'll go one, two, three. One, two, three. Hold on. One, two, three. Yes. Perfect. There you go. Beautiful. Oh, that. No, that went over too far, didn't it? This one goes one, two, three. This one goes one, two, three, four. Alright, so this one goes one, two, three. This one goes one, two, three, four. Honestly, four is fine as well. Fine. That's not a big deal. It should be plenty of integrity in the front, in the middle. Let's take some of these out. Okay. And then one, two, three. Ah, damn it! Three. Right. One, two, three. There we go. I think having three spaces in between the pillars is overkill. So if every once in a while it's four, it should be fine as well. I think most people do like five. So. Alright, let's go this way. We could probably set these down now. Is that lined up? It's lined up there. Lined up there. It's hard to tell with these underwater if they're lined up or not. Okay. And then right here. Beautiful. What? I picked it back up. Where did it go? There it is. Wow, we have just enough rebar on us. That worked out. That worked out. Three. One, two, three. But one, two, three. Four. But okay, that's fine. That's what it. Oh, come on, seriously. Should probably be doing this from the top, but whatever. Losing one here and there isn't a big deal. Okay, and that's, you get the idea of the bridge now. That's the idea of the bridge, and we're just gonna go all the way across with that. And let's put down the remaining of our trussing, and then we will head home. And this is gonna be the whole bottom. As long as the rock goes at least out this far. Like, we're gonna need some there. And some there. We're gonna need quite a bit here. Problem is, we didn't get the rock back, and now we're spending rock, but that's okay. Not that big of a deal. Like I said, when you can TNT mine, this stuff isn't really that big of a deal. No more rock on me. Alright, well, let's just finish over here. We know this side is good. Come on. See the metal right here? This crappy metal? As long as that's below As long as it's got rock below it, or at least some kind of earth, whether it's dirt, rock, or whatever, I'm okay with it. This bridge should be hella strong. Alright, let's get back. Let's get back home. We'll dump off everything we're gonna need to build, and then we will just run home. We probably should have left a little earlier, maybe like another hour earlier. I can't believe I didn't have any zombies there. I must have cleared out the area somehow. Okay, what are we going to need for the build? We're going to need the iron. Well, we could take some iron with us. We might want some at the base. We're not going to need that. Scrap iron? We'll leave a couple scrap iron here. Could use it to upgrade the trunk tips. Could leave the gravel here. Leave the wood. And it looks like we could probably take most everything else. Yeah. Okay. Should we hit the airdrop on the way back? Probably should, because when we come back here, we're going to be full. Let's hit the airdrop on the way back. I don't feel comfortable, though. It's a little late for this kind of shenanigans. And the thing is, I don't have any anything that lets me sprint permanently. Like, I don't have any stamina regen items. But I think we'll make it. See you later, zombies. Man, that was a really good build there. I'm really happy I got to get that much done without any problems. The TNT going off? Pretty sweet, pretty sweet. Might have to up the spawn a little bit, though. We're on high spawn, but I could put it up to max. Maybe I'll do that at some point. I don't want to do it while building my base, though, because if you put up to max, it's going to be really hard for me to build my base. But putting up to max would be a nice way to test the base. I believe I stumbled upon an airdrop. I actually turned my airdrops off before this video. I think I'm going to turn them back on just because I could happen across them. And look at that. That's a good airdrop. That's a damn good airdrop, actually. Really good airdrop. Sheesh. I'm not a big fan of the SMG. Some people ask me why I don't like the SMG. Oh, look at how far I could see my base from. That's awesome. Some people ask me why I don't like the SMG. I feel like the SMG does not do enough damage, and it throws away too many bullets. Like, you know, you're just spraying bullets. And yeah, you'll kill some zombies, but you're going to go through a lot of bullets. And there's only so much brass, you know? So, I like the pistol or the sniper rifle because it's more, you know, surgical. You know, just pop, you know? Alright. We are home. Love this home. We still got to furnish it, though. That'll be a Hub City run thing, though. Gotta get some beds and, like, some nice stuff like that. Okay, so let's take a look at our supply chests. Man, we are kicking ass. We really are. As a matter of fact... Okay, here's the deal between bandages and first aid kits. First aid kits heal you for 50 right away, and then like another 50, I believe, over 6 seconds. I'm not sure exactly how much it heals you for, but it heals you for like a lot, like a lot. And when your wellness is low, or maybe not even that high, like I don't even consider 119 really high, a lot of that healing gets wasted. That's why I like the bandages, the healing bandages. Healing bandages are nice because it's just 2 hit points per second for like however many seconds it goes. It removes bleeding, and like they should be really easy to make. The problem is there's no aloe plants in the game, or there is, but they're very rare unless you find a desert biome. I don't like finding desert biomes, and I'll tell you why. I really, really enjoy the fact that glass jars are very hard to get. I really like it. If you find a desert biome, you start throwing sand into your forge. Those glass jars get made by the buttload, and it's a little boring, to be honest. So I really don't like the sand part of the desert biome. But if you want aloe plants, the desert biome is where you gotta go. I got an easy fix for that, and I'm pretty sure it's gonna happen at some point. Let us farm the aloe plants like everything else. Because there are aloe plants in, like, towns and stuff. Like, I don't know if you saw, but in some of these towns, there's aloe plants in, like, gardens and everything, like, around the house. Let us grab some of those and start farming it. That would be a perfect thing. So, basically, what my point is, first aid kits are a lot better for you when you are higher wellness. So, I'm not going to keep first aid kits on me. I'm going to save them for when I get more wellness. Yeah. We don't need 9 antibiotics. I should start taking these antibiotics once a day. Maybe I should start taking the antibiotics every morning at 7. How about that? Now, the reason I don't... A lot of people tell me, Cage, keep taking the antibiotics. They give you a wellness boost right away, and they, over time, up your wellness as well. They're really good for wellness. They also make you immune to infection. The reason I don't take them is because I don't want to ever get to a point where I don't have enough. But having 11 is quite a bit. I'll take a couple of these over the next few days. But I'm not going to take too many. SMG... You know what we need? We need... Yeah, we need to make some more coffee. Yeah. Oh, I do have some grain alcohol. Yeah, we need to make some more coffee. Let's make some more coffee. Tallow. And let's grab one of these bad boys. Coffee's very quick, too, which is pretty cool. 15... 19, 19, and 19. That's perfect. A little over what we need for the cooking. I honestly do not care. Got a bunch of tallow. Let's grab the tallow. And make some torches. Should we make torches or should we make candles? I don't really like candles very much. Although they do look pretty cool, I guess. No, let's not make anything just yet. Let's just put these away. Where do I put them? Oh, yeah, up here. Tallow. We do not have a lot of paper. Paper's gonna be a problem. I'm telling you, paper's gonna be a problem. Do I have any ammo saved up? That's the question. No. That's a problem. Shotgun shells. Let's make some shotgun shells. Do we have any brass? That's a good question. Oh, barely got any brass. Ah! I really need to go farming. Yeah. I really need to go farming in a big way. Okay, well... Yeah, let's make shotgun shells. This... Did I put the coal in that chest at the other base? I'm pretty sure I did. I hope I did. Please don't tell me I'm down to 16 coal. That would make me cry inside. Alright, shotgun shells. Yeah, I think one more build video, and then I'm gonna have to go on at least one or two, runs somewhere. I don't remember if I cleared out this entire, town. But, maybe we should go on an exploration video. It doesn't look like we've explored a lot. I'm just not ready for an exploration video, to be perfectly honest. I think we should hit this town. What we'll do is we'll go to this town, not next video, but the video after. We'll do one more building video. And we'll go to the town and just hit up the brass. Oh, wait, no, this is supposed to be a building video. Yeah, this is supposed to be my second building video. All right, let me pause the video here so you guys don't have to burn out the night. And I'll come back and I will do... What I'll do is I'll continue building for this video. But when this video is over, I'm going to hit the town... for episode 25, so I will see you guys in a bit. Okay, here we are, and at the base, I did some TNT mining. I went ahead and made some more concrete mix. I've got some more of the concrete stuff being cooked over there. I took a whole stack of iron ingots and I made a bunch of trussing. I made some rebar frames. I grabbed my hammer, and I think we are just about ready now. So let's oh yeah, by the way, I didn't realize when I was complaining about bullets last video, or maybe in this video, I don't remember what video, but I actually had a bunch of casings already, like forger casings, so I went ahead and made a bunch more bullets for my pistol, and I also made some weapon repair kits, although I'm still very, very short on oil, but gun oil, but yeah, shouldn't be a problem. First thing we're going to want to do here is we're going to want to upgrade this reinforced concrete on the bottom. Number one priority. There we go. You don't want this stuff getting attacked when it's not upgraded, because it'll go down very quickly. So let's get it nice and upgraded. And what we're doing for you guys who don't play this game, or maybe one of your first videos watching, basically we've got some rebar frames there, and we're going to upgrade it using wood to a wood frame. And then we're going to take the cement mix and pour cement mix into it. And it'll take like a few in-game hours to dry, but once it dries, it will be upgraded reinforced concrete, which is the hardest structure in the game. Which is why I'm going to trust it to hold up my house. Alright, there we go. Alright. This does take a lot of materials, but I think in the long run, it's going to be worth it. You can't put a price tag on having a house that's sturdy and not going to, like, you know, fall down. It's not even about me losing the house that I built either, although that would suck. It's more about the fact that if my chests fall, I lose everything in them. So, yeah. Kind of important to make sure your house isn't going to fall down. Okay. Okay. Now we can put that away, and we can take out some of our trussing and continue building this bridge. Alright, so 1, 2, 3. That goes down to the bottom. Wait. There we go. 1, 2, 3. Got a lot of supports down here. A lot of supports. 1, 2, 3. That comes out another one, so let's go this way. Let's go over here. 1, 2, 3. Oh, damn you. It's really annoying to do this, like, in the water. Just keep bobbing up and down. It's freaking irritating. There we go. I'm gonna knock that out right now because it's bothering me. I'm also going to check the zombie spawns next time I record. This is the last recording for this session for me. But next time I record, I'm going to check the zombie spawns, because, I mean, I'm pretty sure it's on high. I don't know why there's no zombies here. There is a game mechanic in, that you can, like, clear out an area, and then it will be, like, clear of zombies for a few days. But I don't know. I thought they took that out. I don't know if that's what's going on here. Sounds like a pig's getting killed over there. Not my problem, pig. Okay, so then you can go up there, and I will bring you down here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now, here's the question. Do I want to put the walls in first? Probably not. Now, let's keep doing what we're doing. This seems to be working well. If it's working, then don't stop doing it. That's my motto. Alright, so let's start from this side now. 1, 2, 3, 4... Okay, let's go line up the other side as well. So that means, do we have some stone with us? We do not have some stone with us. Let's go get some stone. Might have to rebuild some of the portions under that got blown up. Now, I put my chest really far back here, but, I don't know. If there's a horde coming across that bridge, it makes me feel better to know my chest is way back here. Actually, you know what? Keep the shotgun on there. We're not going to need the pickaxe. We might need the pickaxe, but I don't think so. okay. It looks like we're going to have to rebuild it a little bit on the right side, possibly a little bit underneath. But I think overall, we did a pretty good job with the dynamite. Yeah, we'll have to rebuild a little bit. This part's going to have to get rebuilt, and anywhere behind it. Okay. That's got to be supported completely. All the way down to the ground. That didn't even need to come out. Whatever. Worry about that later. It's all gotta be solid underneath. There we go. Alright. Alright. Is that even supported? It doesn't look like it is. Well, that one doesn't need to be supported. 1, 2, 3. So that's fine. Which means that this one didn't need to be supported either. Oh yeah, it did, because it's gonna come out 3. This is the first line right here. You know what? Let's do this. 1. No. No, no, no. No, that'd be right here. Okay. So that's 1, 2, 3 unsupported. Yeah, yeah, so that's fine. This should all be able to come right out. I should be able to do this with no issues whatsoever. There we go. Unsupported right there. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? Yes. There we go. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this one's right here. Yes, yes. I'm just lining it up on the other side. There we go. Actually, I could just do this, can I? Right here. Right there. That should be lined up. 1, 2, 3, 4, and the middle will be 5. Well, 4 full. There we go. Alright, alright, we're almost done mapping this thing out. This is going a lot smoother than I thought it would. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Wow, look at that. Look at that, my friends. Could not have been any more perfect. I didn't even do the math on that. I just figured, you know, I was kind of guessing. Wow. Just wow. Oh, God. Now, if that bridge doesn't stay up, I don't know what the hell to do. Alright, so let's do this. Let's bring this back. And let's do some upgrading here. Maybe I'll fit another one underneath there. Nope. Should be okay. And the cool thing with having these redundant, supporting structures underneath is that if something happens and one gets knocked out, it's not going to collapse the whole thing. You don't want every single structure underneath to be vital, because then if one gets knocked out, you're in trouble. Redundancy is a very good thing. Okay. There we go. Okay. All right, one more set and we're done. Okay, so this should be right there. Go. This should be right here. And this should be right here. And this should not be this quiet, this close to the hub city. I'm not complaining, you know? Great. I just drank something I wasn't supposed to. What did I just drink? I wasn't paying attention. What did I drink? Oh, I drank the water. See, if you right click on the water with an open hand, you drink it. And it made me sick, but goldenrod tea will clear me right up. Okay, fair enough. Let's do this. And this. And this. And rebar frames. See why I needed so much iron? And I still probably don't have enough iron to finish this. There we go. Let's switch this out. Let's get up top. I'm sick of being in this freaking water. Oh, let's upgrade these first, though. Some of you might be asking, well, how do you pour concrete into a closed box? If you actually look on top, it's actually not closed. It's there's like an open spot on top. Next time I work with this stuff, I'll show you it. Can't really show it to you right now because my time already went off, and this video is going to be a little bit longer than I intended it to. We're going to need a lot more mining. Probably mine lapses or maybe I'll mine on stream. I'm streaming tonight. Maybe I could do some mining on stream. Okay. We're gonna need that. We're gonna need that. We're gonna need a lot more of the trussing. Maybe not a lot more. Let's not make any more trussing than we really need to, because if we make too much trussing, we won't be using this stuff for pretty much anything else. As a matter of fact, that might be too much. That's okay though. Let's go ahead and eat. Yeah, this is gonna be a pain. Eh, whatever, if I fall, not that big of a deal. There we go. Now I do have some coffee on me, so I don't mind staying like this late now, because I'm not worried about trying to get back in time. Although I didn't have coffee on the last run, and I still made it back in plenty of time. Tell you what, let's go underneath and make sure everything's good under here. This spot is perfect. Yeah, this side's perfect. Let's go back and make sure the other side's perfect. I'm pretty sure the other side is not perfect. Yeah, we still got some work to do over here. This one is supposed to be taken care of. You don't want any holes underneath. Holes underneath will cause structural integrity. If there's an actual, like, mine underneath this thing, it could cause structural integrity problems. I think there's a hole there, but I don't think it'll be that big of a deal. Or maybe it will be. Maybe I should mine it out. By the way, the stuff on top of the bridge is asphalt, and it is the biggest pain in the frickin' ass to mine out. And I'm gonna have to mine some of it out, but I'm putting that off. It's not really that. It's not something that has to be done like right away. All right, that's pretty good. It doesn't match over here, but it's not really that big of a deal. Let's continue putting down the trussing now. And I thought that was too much trussing. Nope. Probably gonna need even more. And then on top of this trussing will be wood flooring, and that will be the that'll be my base, the wood floor. Man, I can't believe I didn't make enough trussing. Not even close. Trussing has a really nice max load on it. Plus, it's supposed to be light. I'd imagine this is the best items for holding up things, and that's why I'm using it. All right, guys, my time went off a little bit ago. This is just going to be me putting down trussing, so I'm going to call this one here. That's going to be it for episode 24. We'll see you next time for episode 25. Till then, take it easy.